So today we are going to learn about single phase full bridge inverter. But before that, let us see one. Let us do one correction in previous a derivation. The correction is in here. So Dn we have calculated like this, but as per the formula which you have studied. You here. So it was that Dn is equal to 1 upon t by 2, the time period divided by t. So it will be 2 by t exactly. So, but we did was one error. So we have taken 1 by t. So from here, a 2 constant will be multiplied here. So everywhere you can do the same. You can multiply this 2 so we can multiply 2 everywhere and so final voltage will come out to be two V by pi N. So we can include it here, 2V by pi. Okay. So this was a small correction in today's class. So now we can move on to single phase full bridge inverter. The functioning of the this new circuit will be same as before. The knowledge of previous circuit analysis will be used here as well, but the circuit will be different, a bit different. So let me draw the circuit for you. So we are having a normal battery. First advantage, the disadvantage which was having in half bridge inverter, we have removed that. Second, we have included here four number of switches now. So now, in half bridge inverter, we were able to do just by two switches, but here there are four switches. So this circuit will be little more costly because there are more number of switching devices and. Therefore, the drive will also be more complex. The control circuitry will be more complex. But the operation is very similar to the previous circuit which we have studied. So these are the four switches. We can also connect anti-parallel diodes, which we have the purpose of which we have studied while doing the half bridge. Inverter. Its sole purpose is just to give a path for current in the load, in the inductive load, to become zero. So this is these are four diodes. Nowadays, these switches, these power electronic switches have the diodes. Pre-installed into itself. So there is a diode across the switch which is connected anti-parallel. Okay, so here we can define the polarity. So plus minus, let us say VL is the voltage across this resistance, that is the load. So mind you, these switches are unidirectional. The current can flow in this direction in these switches, and in diode the reverse, the current will be flowing from bottom to top. So two modes are in which the operation will be completed. So in first mode, what we do, we switch on S1 and S2. S1 and S2 is on, while Q3 and S4 is off. For this, you can draw the circuit. So let us draw the circuit. We will close the S1 and S2 and we will open S3 and S4. So how the circuit will look like? So we are going to close our S1. This is resistive load, so there will be no purpose of showing diodes. Okay. And we are connecting your S2. Okay. S1 and S2 are closed, while your S4 and S3 are open. So this is your VL. And this is your V, the DC source. Okay, so from here, if you just apply the KVL, so this is our loop. Okay, current will be flowing from here, from DC voltage source to the load. So if you see applying KVL here, so minus of V, minus V plus VL will be equal to zero here. So VL will be equal to V. So when S1 and S2 is on, then load voltage is directly equal to the DC voltage source. Now let us see the second mode. In this, S3 and S4 will be on, and S1 and S2 will be off. Okay. So what will be the circuit then? So in the circuit, we have to open S1. So we have open S1. Then the resistance R, and let us show our VL. So now the S3 is closed. Now this S4 is also closed. And S2 is open. Now where the current will flow? This is generating the current in the in this direction. So the current will flow like this. Okay. Now in the load, the current is flowing from negative to positive. In the first circuit, it was from positive to negative. Okay. So now again, we can write the KVL. So minus V, V is this thing, DC voltage source, minus V. Minus VL will be equal to zero. So VL will be equal to minus V. So if we can plot our VL, let us say the pulses are for S1, S2, this is the pulse. And for S3, S4, this is the pulse train. Okay. So this will be like this. Pulse trains will be there. Okay, now we can plot our VL. So what will be VL? VL will be plus V until unless S1 and S2 are closed, and then minus V when S3 and S4 are closed. Again, V plus V and minus. Now you can see the advantage of using four switches here. Now the output voltage, AC voltage, its maximum voltage is coming out to be equal to the DC voltage. So if you want to see the fundamental voltage source, so you can see like this. So the magnitude of this, if you go with your intuition, it should be double the voltage of what we find in half is inverter. So its fundamental voltage will be, the magnitude of that will be 4V pi N pi. So for fundamental N will be 0. So for n is equal to 0, so v fundamental will be 4v by pi. Okay, so it will be this is the maximum voltage. So if we can draw again this thing, it should go little bit up. So this magnitude you can see it is 4V by pi. Okay. Now we can just study the operation of this circuit when we are having a RL load. So let us do. So for RL load, the same circuit is there. Now I'll be showing you the diodes as well. These are the switches and we can connect it diode in anti-parallel. Okay. Then there will be resistance and the inductor. Okay. Switches and diode. It is very simple. You just need to connect the diodes in anti-parallel to the switches. And all diodes are being shown here pointing towards the same direction. So it will be easy enough to remember as well the circuit. So this is S1, this is this is S2, D2, D3, S3, D1, S4 and D4. Let us say plus minus the polarity of the load. Okay. So now just as we have done in the previous case, at the starting we will assume that a negative current is flowing in the in this circuit. So negative current means this current. Okay. I0. So I0 is flowing in this circuit. So at t is equal to 0, the S3 and S4 was on. Okay. So we can show here. So this is your S1 and S2 pulse train. Okay. Like this. So just for clarity, I will draw a negative pulse as well for negative t. This pulse is for S3, S4. So now you may understand that before t is equal to 0, S3 and S4 were on. And at t is equal to, let us say, t by 2 time, t is equal to t by 2 time, S3 and S1 and S2 were off and S3 and S4 are on. This we can draw for t. So you can see the switching frequency of these devices is t. Is 1 by t. So t is the time period of both the switches. So both switches are operating with the same frequency. The switch, just the switching on time is different for both set of switches. Okay. So now we can draw for VL. So VL will be positive when S1 and S2 is on. And VL will be negative when S3 and S4 are off. So VL will be plus V positive and minus V negative. Now, just we need to draw the current waveform, because this is RL loop and current cannot switch. So let us say that let me draw the negative voltage as well. So this is minus V. Okay. So at t is equal to zero, let us say minus I naught current was flowing in the load. The direction was from right to left, as shown in the diagram. Okay. So at that time, S3 and S4 were on. Now what you have to do, you have to switch off S3 and S4 and switch on S1 and S2. So at t is equal to zero, I naught current is flowing. I naught is flowing. Let me show the terminal A and B. Let me say flowing from B to A terminal. Okay. Now let me draw that circuit. So also it is to be noted that we are switching on S1 and S2 at that time. So let me close this S1. So there is the resistance load. Now S1 and S2 is closed. And S3 and S4 are open. Your S3 and S4 is open. Your current is flowing in this direction. Okay. Now, as per this circuit, this battery is generating a current I that need to flow in the load in this direction. So the current need to jump from minus I naught, which is shown in the curve, to I, which is not possible. Instantaneously, the current cannot change in the load like this from negative to positive, because we are having inductors. So inductor will let the current, it will change from I naught to I, but it will take some time. It will not be done instantaneously. First, I naught need to be zero. I naught has to reach zero, and then it will reach to I. So how this can be done? Because I naught to decrease to zero, there should be a path on which in which the I naught could flow. There should be a current path. But here, if you see S1 and S2, they both can conduct the current in a single direction. It can conduct the current in one direction. So what will happen? So the current will take the diode path. So the diode which you have connected across these switches, that will conduct. So this is D2 and this is D1. So how this I naught will flow? So I'll show that in red. So I naught will flow, take D1 path, then it will come to this source. Power will be sent to the source again, then it will return from D2, it will come back. So this is the path of the current I naught that will decay to zero. And as soon as it decays to zero, your current from the DC source, which is V here, let me change the color. So V is the DC voltage source, So as soon as I naught is zero, now the DC source can inject its power, its current into the load. So at steady state, the current will be I in this circuit. So for the time when the current is becoming zero, which components are conducting? It is D1 and D2. D1 and D2 are conducting till the current is zero, and after that S1 and S2 can conduct. Okay. So now the thing can go on. So now at t is equal to T by 2, I current is flowing. Let me say that I is equal to I naught. Okay. So I'll just remove this. And let me draw again. So for t is equal to t by 2, I is flowing from which A to B, it is plus, you have just seen it, or just rewind your video. So you can see the current is flowing from A to B. And what you are doing, you are switching off S1 and S2 and switching on S3 and S4. So I will draw the this circuit again with S3 and S4 to be on. Okay, so this is S3 and this is S4. Now what current is flowing? The current is I. And as per the circuit, what current need to be flowing? It is, let me say, I naught need to flow in negative direction. Okay, but at t is equal to t by 2, I current is flowing. So what need to be done? The diodes connected across these switches will conduct, and it will let the current I to become zero. So I will show this in red again. So this I will take the load then to this diode is D3 here, then to the source, then again come back and reach here. So this is diode D4. So what is happening? I has to become zero. So I will become zero. Until then, what component will be conducting? Your D3 and D4 will be conducting. D3 and D4 will be conducting. And then again, the current is zero, I current is zero. Now I naught current can increase in the positive direction. So this will be. So at steady state, at t is equal to capital T second, I naught current will be flowing from B to A. In the whole operation of this single phase inverter, full bridge single phase inverter, one thing should be noted that this S1 switch S1 and S4 should not be in any circumstances be on simultaneously, because if these two are on, then they would short circuit this DC source, and a very heavy current will flow in this loop. That is why it is always avoided that both these switches in any of the leg is on simultaneously. So likewise, see here, for any time, both these switches are not on. S1 and S4 or S2 and S3. So in any practical circuit, what we do, we create just a delay time. For some delay time, the pulses are not given to the switches. Okay. So in any practical circuit, it is customary to just protect the short circuiting of your DC input source. Then the next thing in here, we can understand the control of this output voltage. Like if you want to control the amplitude or frequency of output voltage, VL, then how we can do it? So most basic practice is to reduce the width of these pulses. So if S1 and S2, I should use a separate slide to explain the same. So make it control of output voltage of a single of an invert. Okay, so how we can do? We just need to reduce the pulses, the firing which we have provided to the switches. So let's just see here. If we just reduce the pulses, width of these pulses, this may be given to S1 and S2. The next set of pulses, pulse train, can be taken as, let us say, this is T/2. So from T/2, same we will do this is at T is equal to T, and then the pulse is repeat itself. Now we are not giving the pulse to the switch, the firing signal to the switch for a whole T/2 time. We have reduced the width of this pulse. Okay, then what will happen to our load voltage VL? So VL will also be just taking the same shape as the pulses. When S1 and S2 is on, then VL is equal to V, and when S3 and S4 is on, then VL is minus V. And the thing will proceed. Here, if we say that the switches are on for T on time, then what will be the VL? Magnitude of this VL? We have seen that it was 4B by pi. The amplitude was this for the fundamental AC signal that was generated. And let me say it has to be omega t, where omega is equal to 2 pi by t. Okay. Now, in this, just one constant will be multiplied, which you can say as to be T on divided by T by 2. Only for this a fraction of T by 2, the circuit is on. So we can say VL is equal to MA into 4 MA. V by pi sine omega t, where MA is what? MA is T on divided by T by 2. This MA is called amplitude modulation index. So by just varying this MA, by varying the T on time, with respect to T by 2, we can change the amplitude of your output AC voltage. And if we want to change this frequency of the AC which we have generated, then what we need to do is very simple. You just need to vary this the time period of the switching of each switches. If we reduce the switching time period, then or increase the frequency of switching the switches, then the frequency of your AC voltage source will also change. Okay. So here it is to be noted that higher the frequency of the switches, higher will be the frequency of the output voltage source. So if we see, if we consider all these harmonics of this voltage source, then we can write 4 MA V by pi sine omega t. This is your fundamental. This is voltage signal in the output at fundamental frequency, plus 4 MA V by 3 pi sine 3 omega t. And likewise, it will just go on till infinity. Just higher the order of the harmonics, lower will be its amplitude, voltage amplitude, and higher will be the frequency. And it is very very common. You must have understood as well in your networks that the higher the frequency of a voltage signal, it is easier to filter out it by designing filters. It will need a very small size capacitors and inductors to filter out that signal, high frequency signal. And for lower frequency signal, it is very hard to design filters. So if you want to filter out these two components from the output voltage. So if we don't want these two in the output signal, then we need to design filters which can filter out these two components or the other components as well. So it is very best to just have a circuit in which we can switch the switches at very high frequency, because if we can do that, then we can generate harmonics at very high frequency. They will be at very high frequency, and which will be easier to filter. So that is why the concept of sinusoidal modulation method came into picture, which is also called pulse width modulation technique of generating pulses for these switches. So let us carry on with that, and that is your next topic. That is sinusoidal modulation technique. Sinusoidal modulation technique. So let us just have a small briefing of this. So what we are going to do, we are going to use the same circuit, the full bridge inverter. Just the pulses which we are generating for the switches to switch on, that technique we are going to talk about. That how we are going to generate the pulses for these switches. So for that, let me just introduce two signals. Okay, so one is the triangular pulse. We will generate triangular pulses of a fixed frequency. Okay, so just you can practice this at home. So we will be using this triangular pulse, triangular signal. We call it as the carrier signal. And then we talk about a modulating reference signal. Okay. So your modulating reference signal will be a sinusoidal quantity. Okay. So we will talk about a second signal, which is called modulating reference signal. So let me take two complete cycle of this carrier signal. That's to be the half cycle of that. Okay. this is called modulating signal. And now we are going to compare these two signals with each other. Okay. So let me say carrier signal as the amplitude of carrier signal as AC and amplitude of modulating signal as AM. So if the modulating signal is greater than the carrier signal at any time, then a pulse will be generated. Then pulse generated. Okay. And if AC is smaller, AC is greater than AM, then pulse will be absent. Now just see how at what time we are going to study this. So this is first intersection point, so I will just draw a line. Then this is the second. Then this is the third. Then this one. This simultaneously you can draw in your copy as well. So it will just get be helpful in practicing this as well. Or for time pass ki ho jayega. Okay, now we will use this guideline to generate our pulses. So just see in the first reason, this reason we are going to talk about. So in this your AC is greater than AM. Now the amplitude of AC is higher than AM. This is higher than this. In this reason, so there will be no pulse generated. Okay, and after that you can see a bigger reason, a wider reason is there, where AC is smaller than AM, then we can generate a pulse. Okay, then again AC is greater than AM, so no pulse. Then again some pulse. So the thing can go on. Just see. Now, if we give this pulse to our switches, which switch? The H bridge, which we talked about. So this is your S1, this is your S2, S3, and S4. So we are generating the pulses for S1 and S2. Okay, and the invert of this pulse is pulse ka invert. Matlab jahan pulse hai wahan pe zero, jahan pe pulse nahi hai wahan pe pulse dena hai. Jaise ki ye iska just ulta,
S1 है S2 को जो पल्स दे रहे हैं उसका जस्ट उल्टा। क्या सेंस है इसका ये करने का? इतना ही सेंस है कि S1 और एक ही लेग में, इस ब्रिज के एक ही लेग में जो दो स्विचेज हैं उनको हम साइमल्टेनियसली स्विच ना करें, स्विच ऑन ना करें, तो उससे क्या होगा, उससे हमारा डीसी जो इनपुट सोर्स है वो शॉर्ट नहीं होगा। ओके, देन दिस इज फॉर S3 एंड S4। ओके, नाउ व्हाट विल बी योर वोल्टेज? Just see what will be your load voltage. For when S1 and S2 is on, then VL will be what? VL will be equal to V, isn't it? We have studied this. And when S3 and S4 is on, then VL will be minus V. So similarly, we can do it. So this will be minus plus. All minus, then plus. So this is our load voltage. If you can see, this load voltage is similar to our modulating signal, means when the modulating signal is high, then you will see the load voltage is very high. Just see in this region, when the modulating signal is high, then VL is high. When modulating signal is low, then your VL is also low. When modulating signal is negative, just see negative, then your VL is also negative. So VL is quite similarly behaving as our modulating signal. तो इसका अगर फोरियर सिग्नल आप निकालेंगे, फोरियर एनालिसिस करेंगे, तो आपको इसका जो फंडामेंटल मिलेगा वो मॉड्यूलेटिंग सिग्नल के बराबर ही मिलेगा। Means we are able to generate AC voltage at the output whose switching frequency is very high, but your fundamental frequency is not changing much. जो output voltage में fundamental frequency है वो तो modulating signal के frequency के बराबर ही होगी। अगर मॉड्यूलेटिंग सिग्नल को हम 50 हर्ट्ज रखते हैं उसकी फ्रीक्वेंसी, तो हमारी जो आउटपुट पे फंडामेंटल फ्रीक्वेंसी आएगी वो भी 50 हर्ट्ज ही आएगी। सो द मॉड्यूलेटिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ मॉड्यूलेटिंग सिग्नल डिफाइन द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द फंडामेंटल ऑफ आउटपुट एसी सिग्नल। सो द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ modulating signal defines the fundamental AC output voltage। तो यहां पे देखिए कितना आसान है output voltage का frequency change करना। आपके जो मॉड्यूलेटिंग सिग्नल है, जो कंट्रोल सिग्नल है, उसकी वैल्यू बहुत ही 5 वोल्ट तक मान लीजिए उसकी कंट्रोल सिग्नल, तो ये 5 वोल्ट डिसाइड करेगा कि आपकी आउटपुट वोल्टेज की फ्रीक्वेंसी कितनी होगी। समझ रहे? अगर मॉड्यूलेटिंग सिग्नल को हम 50 हर्ट्ज सेट करते हैं तो आपकी आउटपुट वोल्टेज की फ्रीक्वेंसी कितनी होगी? 50 हर्ट्ज होगी। ओके, और जो स्विचेस की स्विचिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी है, जिस फ्रीक्वेंसी पे हम लोग स्विचेस को ऑन या ऑफ कर रहे हैं, वो डिफाइन होता है हमारे कैरियर सिग्नल से। So the frequency of carrier signal defines the switching frequency of the switches. So normally जो ये carrier signal की frequency होती है उसको हम लोग ज्यादा रखते हैं modulating signal से. Okay, तो यहाँ पे हम कुछ एक parameter define कर सकते हैं. एक है frequency modulation index. That is frequency modulation index. ये क्या होगा? MF, which will be defined by frequency of the carrier signal upon frequency of the modulating. MF जितना ज्यादा होगा उतनी ही ज्यादा frequency पे आप switches को turn on और turn off करोगे और उतने ही ज्यादा frequency पे आपकी harmonics generate होंगी. तो आपको आप उनको फिल्टर आउट भी आराम से कर सकते हैं. और दूसरा एक कांस्टेंट है दैट इज एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन कांस्टेंट. एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन इंडेक्स एमए. दिस इज डिफाइंड बाय वी M upon B carrier signal. जो modulation VM peak we should say. So this is the relation between the maximum voltage of your modulating signal and the maximum voltage of your carrier signal. इन दोनों का रेशियो तो हमने देखा है. अगर उसको आप और फूरियर सीरीज में जाके उसको पूरा सॉल्व करें कि VL इज इक्वल टू एम ए इंटू वी. ओके, VL का एम्पलीट्यूड amplitude of VL. is MA into V. तो आप कहेंगे जितना ज्यादा सब मॉड्यूलेशन इंडेक्स होगा एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन इंडेक्स होगा उतने ज्यादा हमें आउटपुट वोल्टेज मिल जाएगा. V तो यहाँ पे डीसी वोल्टेज सोर्स है और VL हमारा आउटपुट वोल्टेज है तो जितना ज्यादा हमें वोल्टेज चाहिए उतना ज्यादा हम MA को बढ़ा सकते हैं. तो यहाँ पे देखने वाली चीज है कि MA मैक्सिमम टू मैक्सिमम वन होना चाहिए. वन हो सकता है मतलब कि अगर आप इसको फिर से पूरा देखें तो आप इन पल्सेस को कितना बढ़ा सकते हैं? यूनिटी तक भी तो बढ़ा सकते हैं. जैसे कि आपने उसमें फुल ब्रिज में देखा था उसको मैं दिखा देता हूँ एक बार. यहाँ पे आपने देखा था ये टी ऑन टाइम आप कितना बढ़ा सकते हो मैक्सिमम. मैक्सिमम टी बाई टू तक ही वो तो बढ़ा सकते हैं हम. हाँ, कम करने के लिए काफी कम कर सकते हैं लेकिन बढ़ाने के लिए कहाँ तक बढ़ाएंगे? टी ऑन विल बी मैक्सिमम टी बाई टू. तो एम ए कैन बी मैक्सिमम टू मैक्सिमम. Here in this case it is 0.5. In this case also this MA will be maximum to maximum unity. So similar case is there as well. कि MA की value हम 1 रख देते हैं, unity modulation index रख सकते हैं. और MA की value अगर हम बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ाते हैं, अगर यहाँ पे MA की value हम बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ा देते हैं इस साइनसॉइडल मॉड्यूलेशन सिग्नल जो है इसकी मैग्नीट्यूड अगर बहुत ज्यादा हम बढ़ा देते हैं तो रेड इंक से मैं इसको मार्क करता हूं. मान लीजिए आपने इसको बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ा दिया, मान लीजिए ऐसे कर दिया आपने, तो आप देखो हमेशा मॉड्यूलेटिंग सिग्नल इज ग्रेटर देन योर ट्रायंगुलर पल्स, ट्रायंगुलर सिग्नल। तो बहुत ही कम इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट मिल रहे हैं आपको जहां पे आपकी पल्सेस जनरेट होंगी, तो ऐसा होगा कि बहुत देर तक आपके S1 S2 ही ऑन रह रहा है, बहुत देर तक S3 S4 ही ऑन रह रहा है, तो उससे ज्यादा फायदा नहीं होगा। ओके, फायदा कब होगा, जब हम 1 तक रखते हैं इसको, एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन इंडेक्स अगर 1 तक हो तो मैक्सिमम बेनिफिशियल। अब यहां पे अभी आपने जो पढ़ा है ये है, दिस इज योर बाइपोलर मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक, बाइपोलर मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक, यहां पर मैं लिख देता हूं बाइपोलर मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक। बाइपोलर किस लिए, क्योंकि यहां पे जो आउटपुट वोल्टेज है वो प्लस भी हो रही है माइनस भी हो रही है। ओके, इतना अच्छे से आपको ये साइनसॉइडल नहीं दिख रहा होगा क्योंकि प्लस भी हो रहा है माइनस भी हो रहा है, दोनों पोलैरिटी आ रही है। ओके, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड बाइपोलर। ओके, तो अगर आप यूनिपोलर पढ़ेंगे तो आपको यूनिपोलर में थोड़ा सा और अच्छे से बीएल दिखेगा। तो जब इसका हम लोग इसमें फूरियर एनालिसिस करते हैं बीएल में और इसमें हम हार्मोनिक्स देखते हैं तो हार्मोनिक्स ज्यादा मिलता है। तो हार्मोनिक्स तो हमें हमेशा मिनिमम ही रखना चाहिए, विच इज बेस्ट फॉर द सिस्टम। तो चलिए हम यूनिपोलर मॉड्यूलेशन इंडेक्स भी पढ़ लेते हैं। यूनिपोलर मॉड्यूलेशन टेक्निक, सो द सेम the same so we have to use one triangular pulse, so let us draw that, let us complete four cycle of that. Okay. So this is 2, 3, and 4. So this is our triangle scheme. So first modulating signal we can draw as like this. And the second modulating signal we can draw in red. So just first complete this one, this first task. The same thing we are repeating as we have done in the previous bipolar technique. Let me just draw the reference circuit so that I can talk about that.
So this is S1, S2, S3, and S4. So let me define one terminal. It's A and B terminal. So in this, what we will be done, we will give this pulse, the pulse generated by comparing these two signals to only S1. So let us let me draw the intersection point. So let me generate the pulses by comparing these two, as we have done in the bipolar modulation technique. Practice it well. This is going to be important. So how the pulses will be generated? When the amplitude of your modulating signal is greater than amplitude of carrier signal, gate pulse will be generated. Gate pulse generated for the switch. And when your AM is less than AC, then gate pulse will be absent. Okay, so let us complete our task. So this will be zero here, because here amplitude of modulating signal is smaller than the carrier signal. Then we can give the pulse, generate the pulse. And again zero, then again positive, then zero, positive, then zero, then positive. Okay, so this we will give to S1, and to S4 we will give anti pulse. It's just opposite to this, so that S1 and S4 do not short circuit. So when S1 is given pulse, or S1 is on, then what will be VA? What is the potential of VA? If voltage source is a DC voltage source is V, then VA will be equal to V, because now this terminal and this terminal are shorted, so the same polarity will be there. And when S4 is on, then what is VA? VA will be equal to zero. Okay, so I am drawing the pulse of S1, as well as you can say it is VA. Okay, and then I will use a different ink just to differentiate the modulating signal and its pulses. Now a second modulating signal will be used to generate pulses for S3 switch. So this modulating signal will be just 180 degree phase difference with your first modulating signal. So we can just draw the intersection point for this. This will be same. So you can practice it at your place as well. The methods will be same as here. You can draw a more better diagram. I'm using my stylus, so sometimes it is not very very smooth. So next we will generate for S3. Likewise, as we have said, it will be for VB. Now when S3 is on, then VB will be what? S3 is on, then VB will be V. And when S3 is off, then what will be VB? It will be 0. So same case. So here, just see. So in this region, your BM is, AM is smaller than the control signal, so it will be 0. Then we can go positive, then again 0, then positive, then again 0, then positive, bigger bit, smaller than this one. Now, so what is your VL? VL is the potential difference between A and B. This is your output AC voltage. So what is VL? VL is VA minus VB. So what you need to just do, you need to just subtract the second pulse, the red pulse, from the black pulse. So what will be that? That will be VA minus VB. Just see what happens. So this will be, let me draw, let me take a different ink here, or black ink itself. Okay, so this is plus, and then 0, VA minus VB, 0 here. Then again plus, then 0. Then a 0, then plus. Then again 0 for bigger 0. Then now negative. Then 0. Then again negative. Then 0. Then again negative. And then 0. Just see. Now VA minus VB is more is quite sinusoidal. It is looking quite sinusoidal. So if you just do a Fourier analysis of VA minus VB, its harmonics will be very less. Okay, this is called unipolar modulation technique, because your load voltage is not fluctuating from plus minus during the positive cycle. It is just positive from here to here. It is just positive, and after that it is getting negative. So it is a better AC output voltage. Here I have just taken our MF, the modulating frequency modulation index, very low. It is just 4 here. Normally it is in the range of 10 to 20. So a very nice AC signal is visible in that. Okay. So this is your, at this point, your first unit is complete. The inverter's first unit is complete. This is single phase inverter. From the next lecture, we will talk about three phase inverter. So if there is any doubt, just choose any appropriate channel to talk to me and clear your doubt. Okay, thank you. Thank you for now.